And some breaking news just coming in, and this has got to do with the Ambani bomb scare case. The stringent anti-terror law, the UAPA, has been ended in the Ambani resident bomb scare case. Vidya is getting us more details on that. In fact, we'll go to Vidya in a bit from now. But in fact, what has been done right now is that the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act is now being added in the probe relating to the Ambani bomb scare case. So those, in fact, found guilty will be tried and tested under the stringent provisions of the UAPA. Vidya has more details on that story. Vidya, get us more details why an anti-terror law here is being used in the case of the Ambani bomb scare.
Well, the NIA filed an application before the NIA this morning around the 12 o'clock. The application was filed by the special public prosecutor Gonzalez, who very clearly told the court that there needs to be an additional charge that needs to be added. According to the investigating agency, the UAPA is added because there were gelatin sticks that were found and the kind of pertain to terrorism according to the NIA, which the NIA sources have been very clearly saying that since there was a bomb scare that was put out, there was a threat to an eminent personality, and which is one of the reasons why they feel that the UAPA is the stringent act of UAPA is applicable in this case, and certainly for that they will get further time to investigate. Almost 30 days is what an agency gets for investigating, 30 days of remand, yes, compared to an IPC section where only 14 days is given. So certainly this the agency to probe this entire case further and deeply.
All right. Vidya, thanks for getting us up to speed with that.